All right, this one goes out to my daughter who's graduating high school tomorrow, prom queen Francesca. All right, everybody. Gorgeous night out there. Roll your windows down and sing it. No. You bet. All right. My name's Joe Ligotti, the guy from Boston. And, of course, that one goes out every day at 6:30 for my princess, Francesca, who we're very proud of. This is actually her weekend. I can still remember taking her by the hand to meet the middle of the day bus there for kindergarten and being very upset that I had to put her on the bus. Of course, she just went and just was smiling away and, you know, whatever. She always had my personality, kind of never was afraid to go into a situation, which I'm kind of glad. But anyway, we have here at AM 950, 100.3 FM, a friend that is on our Pittsburgh affiliate. And not only is she an extremely attractive woman, and I hate to embarrass her, but I'm sorry. I'm a man, an alpha male. I have to mention that. Even though it's a Me Too thing, I know I'm in trouble now. She is the a wholesale mortgage broker, and it's Mohsin. Am I saying that right?
It's Mohsin.
Mohsin, sorry.
It's okay.
You got to tell the dumb Italian kid, don't pronounce the H. Anyway, but it is a mortgage corporation designed to serve your financial needs. They offer the best possible rates from the Federal Housing Administration, or FHA, specializing in federally backed loans. And if you want to get in touch with her or, you know, get a loan or, you know, borrow some money, otherwise, but if you don't pay her back, she's going to call me. Anyway, mmcmtg.com. So, Sara, you're in town, and, of course, we want to mention why you're in town. It's a very special reason.
It is, and thank you, Joe, for having us.
Anytime.
On. Really.
Oh, and Zaff's here.
Yeah, the brother.
The brother, all right? Not my brother, the brother.
Right, yeah. Yes, the brother.
All right, go ahead.
Well, we're just really happy to be here on air with you because one of the key parts of this weekend is Special Olympics. The Summer Games are on, so you and I were kind of connected that way because we support that and a couple of nonprofits that are very meaningful to us. Every month when we have a show that we offer to a nonprofit, so we have either Special Olympics or Power Forward, which was Kevin Stevens on addiction. And so this is an exciting period for the Summer Games. We have some wonderful athletes. We just had Lumine, her actual name, they call her Lightning because she's a super athlete. She runs really fast. So they're going to be holding events on Friday at Boston University.
BU, yep.
And Harvard Saturday, Sunday.
Okay, so, that's a nice place to go. I mean, Harvard Stadium, very, very historic. That's where they have the game.
It is.
You know, the game, they call it the game. Harvard, Yale. Anyway, but the reason why we're connected is my Anthony was an athlete and had participated in Special Olympics. My son is both developmentally challenged and also physically challenged. And he was able to compete for a couple, 3 years. Mm-hmm. And Anthony has done really well and met an awful lot of nice folks. And it was kind of nice. Sometimes when you're the parent of a challenged kid, you tend to kind of stay off to yourself because I don't know if it's not. I don't want to put this the wrong way. Because you're so involved with your child. All right. So other families are there, you know, are doing things with their kids that, you know, appropriate for age and what have you. But when you have a challenged kid, there's so many challenges, never mind just going out in public sometimes and being in large groups, you know, is a challenge. So Special Olympics is just a great organization started by the Shriver family.
Yes.
And it gives folks that, I hate to say this word too, but kind of don't fit in the typical puzzle piece, but still have great athletic ability and can feel that competitive spirit and what it feels like to win. Because a lot of these kids don't get that every day because of their challenges. So it's really nice what, and again, you know, the Shriver is, of course, was a Kennedy sister.
Yes.
And she's still, she's 90 what? She's got to be.
Right, she's in her 90s. And yeah. I mean, one of the key things, that it's nice that you said that, it allows parents and families and communities to come together. Mm-hmm. And embrace that, you know, ability to grow as well. Because it's not only just about the child. It's there are adults, you know, they reach up to over 70 years of age who are athletes globally.
Mm-hmm.
And we support Special Olympics in Massachusetts and in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Mm-hmm. So one of the families, they've become very close to us. And the son, Giovanni, has actually gone from being an athlete to being a coach. So
that's cool.
That is. And there's such a great feeling, a great deal of joy for us whenever they do come on air and share their story, because it helps other people realize that, you know, there's this wonderful community that exists,
right,
for families to be able to grow and build on. And there's joy from that as well. So,
and the way I want to describe it is, for that weekend, mm-hmm, when you're with all those other folks and folks that support you, and there's an awful lot of people that just, to be honest with you, don't know what to do when they see someone who's physically challenged. I mean, yes, they say hello and they're being that, but you really feel like you belong when you're at a competition, a Special Olympic competition.
Right.
Is that fair to say? I mean,
it is. Yeah. It is. And
yeah, yeah.
I mean, my mom was always involved, you know, with, you know, different organizations. So we were raised, you know, with that perspective. And so for us, wellness, really, when it comes to finances, they go hand in hand. So
mm-hmm,
when it comes to many factors, when you're looking at whether it's Special Olympics or families trying to just be able to choose versus feeling like they're constantly stuck in a place based on financial issues,
mm-hmm,
that those are hard things to talk about. So
true.
We as a family-owned business have been able to provide not just for the person who has like the perfect credit scores. We're talking about everyday folks like myself, my brother, yourself, who may go to the bank and they'll just get a no. We want to buy a home. That's our dream. No, because your credit score is too low. You must have a 660 score. We can go down to 580. But if the score is under 580, we have talked to so many of our folks out there, and we've been able to give them the information because we work with the credit bureau directly. And to provide the education allows that freedom to choose, because when you stop in a place where you just keep getting no's, you know, we've all been there. It's not like, you know, there's no Joneses, there's no one living that perfect life. So firstly,
no,
we have to get over that part and accept that every single person's hit a road where there's just been like no access. And
right,
then there's that one person who says yes, and that's what we are. We're all about yes.
Okay.
Maybe not today, but we will find the solution to get you there. And that's really what is so important now, because of the fact that finances play such a huge role in how you live your life, whether you're sleeping properly, anxiety, yeah, relationships. You know, there's a higher divorce rate based on finances. There's,
wow, I didn't even think of that one.
There's a lot of health issues related to that as well. There's a lot of depression. So these are studies and facts that are based on it. And it's really because it is one of the most taboo things to talk about. Nobody wants to talk about it over dinner with friends. We're here to find solutions. We do it privately. So it's not, we're not addressing it on air. We just have folks call privately and have that conversation. And
how many banks do you work with, you mentioned?
We work with over 50 wholesale banks. So it's like the outlet store. I like to shop. I'm a shopper. So
right,
I like
on.
Yeah. So outlet stores, you get everything for just a lot cheaper. The same thing with interest rates. Our rates are lower, and we can approve you down to 580 scores. If it's lower than that, we'll fix it for free so that you can get to that dream home.
Okay.
Or to get out of debt, refinance. We're licensed in multiple states. So we're about
Mass
saving money.
Too?
Yes.
Oh, good.
Florida, Massachusetts, California, Colorado.
Wow. See that?
But it's financial freedom, and it gives you, you know, once you realize, it takes a long time for, even for myself, when you actually grow up, you could be 100 years old, and you're like, wow, I get to choose how I want to live my life.
Yeah.
A lot of folks don't, you know, You've just got to make that decision and start choosing which way you want to live your life, because it's not about anyone else. It's about you.
So Mohsin Mortgage Corporation, MMCMTG.com, is all about yes. I love yes. So when we come back, we'll still talk a little about money, but I got some fun stuff that is going to make Sarah laugh. No doubt about it. AM 950, 100.3 FM. My name is Joe Ligotti. And yes, we do love the funk here. And sorry, Sarah. I mean, I'm a little nuts, but that's kind of my forte. And I love the old 80s funk. And that's because, you know, my first president, and of course, my father's going to text me again. Yes, Dad, the first president I ever voted for was Reagan. I know you know secretly, but you didn't just like to admit it. I've been screwed up for a lot of years, Dad. Don't worry. But anyway, yeah, my father is a Dukakis Democrat, all right? And not even Dukakis is a Dukakis Democrat anymore, but my father still is. All right, just anyway. But, yeah, so that's why we like that type of music. And listen, it's my show, so David kind of stays in the wheelhouse. And every once in a while he throws one of, you know, the newer stuff. He likes, he's got a really great ear for music. And I think it's also because I met his dad, Steve, who's a great guy and kind of in the same general genre as myself. And, you know, we like all kinds of music. But it's Rick James, I mean, forget about it. I mean, you know what I mean? All right. So what we want to say is that Sara Mohsin now, H is silent. You only have to tell me things once. Well, Paula, you know that's not true. Mohsin Mortgage Corporation. And you can get a hold of them. They are all about yes. All right, we learned that last segment. MMCMTG.com. They are a wholesale mortgage broker. And they work with over 50 banks. And just because you are a 1970 Chevy Impala and you got a few scratches and dents, they're not going to send you to the junkyard. They're going to try to help you go to Mako and make yourself over and get yourself a nice house or your debt off your back, and how's that? So you can afford that trip to Fiji at some point.
Sounds good.
Well, I know. Mm-hmm. All right. Only problem is when I go to the beach, it really gets me very angry. Can't they see I have a cigar in my mouth? I'm a human. The Greenpeace people, you know, they come. Anyway, don't get fresh. All righty. Hey, these are stories that really happened, Sarah. And they kind of... a little crazy. It says in Hackettown, New Jersey. I don't know if you've ever been there. Been to Jersey?
I have, yes. Not okay. There, though.
Okay. No, but so this is something you don't want to admit that you've been to Jersey? Or
no.
No, it's okay. All right. I'm just checking. I don't know. It says authorities say a man drove drunk to a New Jersey police station. I think that's a smart move, right? You know, drunk driving saved them some... save the gas for the town. Anyway, it says where he was picking up a woman who had been charged with operating under the influence.
Even better.
Why, no. I think they make a great couple. We should send them on the dating app to that Bumble Brew place. They would go over big. It said Hackettstown police say 21-year-old Morgan Duran, That sound Irish to you? No. Anyway, I'm not trying to be. What am I? What? I'm 4 miles from South Boston. Do I want to slap or get slapped around? It says, of Netcong, I don't know if that's a town down there, was arrested last Friday after a traffic stop. She was taken to the station where authorities said she contacted 24-year-old Sebastian Rem of Washington Township. Everything's a township down there. I don't know what that is. To pick her up. When Rem arrived at the station, authorities said he smelled of alcohol. I mean, it's kind of like if you were going to be with your girl, you want both of you to eat the scampi. That way, you know, one of you isn't going to smell garlic, right? So he's a drinker, she's a drinker. It all makes sense to me so far. And it says, but both were eventually released to another driver because they charged him with drunken driving also.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, well, I mean, it did save the cops a trip.
Sure did.
They should give him a break for that. I mean, you know what I mean? Reduces bail. All right. A nearly 58-foot sandcastle dubbed the world's tallest. Guess where it was made?
New Jersey.
No, it has not. That's kind of funny because I don't know. I don't think there were any beaches around.
Really?
Well, I probably, you've been there, probably I haven't, but, you know, in all the Hogan's Heroes episodes, I never saw a beach. Anyway, Germany.
Really?
Yeah, it says an international team of artists worked together in Germany to build a 57.94-foot tall sandcastle that broke a Guinness World Record. I don't know. The artists, which included representatives from the Netherlands, Latvia, that actually sounds like a candy.
I know. It sounds like a cake.
Cake.
Like a really delicious cake.
See, we're right here. I understand
it's
cake.
The food connection.
I get cake. All right. I get cake. Poland, Russia, and Hungary. Now, if you're going to have Latvia, which is cake,
yes,
you need somebody that's hungry.
Hungary.
See where I'm going? Sorry. Completed work on the sandcastle yesterday in Binz and was officially measured by the Guinness people and dubbed the world's tallest sandcastle. I guess it surpassed the last one, which was 54.72 foot. Imagine, and that was in 2017. Imagine being those people. I mean, come on. Are you kidding me? For 2.5 feet, they're going to break my chops and take the record away? I don't know, but that's, I guess they had to bring in 11 tons of sand, and they've been working on it since May. Now, wow. In Revere here, once a summer, you know, Revere's the oldest municipal beach in America. That's where people, you know, went to vacation here, Revere Beach. And they do sandcastle, and they are really beautiful. I mean, it's amazing what they can do with art and everything else, you know, with the sand. You know, me, I had trouble making a pyramid. You know, it would always get washed away. Yeah. Zaf, you're looking at me like I'm a little nuts here, but it's all right. You know what I mean? You think I was a normal kid? How did I end up being like this? All right, it says, what looks like a massive storm system on National Weather Service radar is actually a lot of ladybugs. I'll show you the picture. See? Mm-hmm. I don't see one bit of red in there, but that's just me. You know, because you're not supposed to kill a ladybug. Ladybug, go away, come back another day. You know, don't rain. Because if you kill the ladybug, it's supposed to rain or something.
Bad luck. They're good luck.
That was bad luck. Yeah. Okay, I knew it was something bad. I got one of those horns, the Italian horns, so I'm, yeah. I got that covered, the evil spirits. Anyway, it's an Italian thing. It says, looked like a massive storm system on the NWS radar in San Diego County turned out to be just a whole lot of ladybugs. The massive blob, don't look at me, David, when I've said blob, all right? Showed up Tuesday evening on the radar. I guess it was just a large echo from Southern California radar this evening. It's not precipitation, but actually a cloud of ladybugs, termed a bloom. Who knew? All right. Sara Mohsin, thank you so much. And by the way, the guy that won that big Powerball jackpot, fortune cookie. All I get is agita when I eat Chinese food. This guy gets 500 million. Anyway, hug someone you love tonight because life is too short. God bless the Francesca and congratulations on your graduation. Dad loves you. Hey, God bless all our cops, EMTs, and firefighters out there. Please be damn careful protecting us tonight. And God bless all those that have served and continue to serve to protect this nation, the principals, and our children's future. And God bless all those veterans. Happy D-Day anniversary. Polishing up our act, and if you've ever been